So my name is Teresa Duryea Wong, and I'm here at the International Quilt Festival. I've been coming to festival for 16 years, so I've been quilting for a long time. For about 15 years, I hand quilted, and about 2 years ago, I bought a new Bernina and learned to machine quilt. So now I make art quilts, and this is my art quilt that I entered into the festival, into the special exhibition, It's Raining Cats and Dogs. I was inspired to make this after taking a class with David Taylor, but I took David's class because first I saw his quilt Maynard here at the International Quilt Festival. It won one of the Best of Show awards, and it was a true showstopper for me. I came around the corner, I saw that quilt, and it's just one of those impressions that lasted forever. So then I sort of tracked him down and I took a class from him and learned his applique method. This is my own original pattern, but it's made in the style that David teaches. So there's over 200 pieces of applique in this quilt. It's a pattern I drew based on a photo, and my husband and I took the photo. This is of our dog, Chip was his name, and he lived with us for 14 years, and he passed away earlier this summer. So he's about 16 or 17 years old when he passed away. So the applique is all hand applique, and the way it's made is this sort of convex, concave method where all of the applique pieces are nestled into each other. And then it's all hand applique and then machine quilted. The pattern in this method, you really follow the bone structure, the fur of the dog, and not the bone structure. So it's not blocked out by color. You follow sort of the way the fur would go. And then I quilted it the way the fur would go so that it's something like you want to pet him because it's like fur. So I used mostly only four colors, all black, gray, and white, two colors of gray. To machine quilt him. None of the quilting lines cross, so that was a big deal in the quilting process. It would be really clean and pristine. And then the background is stippling, and then just fun lines on the outside border. It has been a dream of mine to enter a quilt for like 10 years. This is the first thing I ever entered, and it got accepted, and I'm beyond thrilled to be here and to be one of the finalists in this show.